Hello students, welcome to our class. Today we are taking our chapter number 8. The name of this chapter is soil. Soil, as we have discussed about our body, our around area, or about the weather, climate, for different types of things which we have very useful to live our life. Then we needed food for growing, for better grow of our body. We need different types of nutrients for our healthy life, and we get these nutrients from the crops. And how will crops will occur? Crops will occur on the soil. Soil is also very useful to us to getting food and also getting more about many of different kinds of things which are very useful to us. So in this chapter, soil, we have more topics about the soil, and using these topics we will know about the things, about the information of the soil, how important soil for us. Soil is very important for us. In this chapter we have detail about the soil. When you wake up in the morning, you can see the sweepers will clean the streets. Whenever we clean our house, we also see the dust will occur on our table, books. Then we can find out dust in our home, on our many things. So where will the dust come here? Dust will come there from the atmosphere, from the wind. Dust is a very tiny particles. It is visible for us. We can easily see dust on our things also. Dust becomes more visible during the storms. When we see the storms, we also feel the dust will come with the storm. Have you wondered what this dust is and where does it come from? It has extremely fine form, solid particles suspended. These are particles of the earth, very tiny particles. You can easily see them in a light beam that enters a dark room. Then it is these particles which settle on your books. As I said to you, they already said they settle down on our books, tables, and many things. We can get the dust on our things by the storms. Whenever we get storms, the dust will come with them. It is a visible particles. In this chapter, we have topics about the soil, formation of the soil, particles of the soil, erosion of the soil. We have more information about the soil available in this our chapter. Soil and its importance. Soil is an important part of land and is one of the most important natural resources. Our first topic is soil and its importance. As I say to you, soil is very important for us because we get the crop which will be grown on the soil. In other ways, soil is also important for us. So first, soil and its importance. Soil is important for us. How? Now we will discuss. First, the soil is defined as the uppermost layer of the earth crust in which plants grow. As we have different climate and weather conditions at our different places like this, we have also soil formate. Particles of soil formates also different from one place to another place. In soil, we can see they have layers in them. First, the top layers, where the trees are grow up, soil always divided in different layers. First, top layers always have fertility. Made of this fertility, the plants and the trees will be grow on this. Plants need soil to grow. All plants and trees, if you want to plants and trees, then plants and trees always grow on land, grow on soil. It helps the plants by holding their roots firmly and providing water and nutrients. Any type of plants and trees, if grow on the land, then soil will provide them water and nutrients, as we all know about the photosynthesis process. During the photosynthesis process, प्लांट्स विल मेक देयर ओन फूड बाय देयर ओन सेल्फ. फॉर डूइंग दिस प्रोसेस, फॉर गेटिंग देयर फूड, दे यूज वाटर, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड सनलाइट. देन हाउ दे विल गेट वाटर? दे विल गेट वाटर फ्रॉम द सॉइल, बिकॉज सॉइल प्रोवाइडेड वाटर देम. ऑल्सो दे प्रोवाइड द न्यूट्रिएंट्स विच दे हैव, दे प्रोवाइड द वाटर एंड न्यूट्रिएंट्स टू द प्लांट्स. सो सॉइल इज एसेंशियल फॉर एग्रीकल्चर. एज आई से टू यू, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू लिव हेल्थी, देन वी नीड डिफरेंट न्यूट्रिएंट्स. एंड हाउ वी विल गेट दिस न्यूट्रिएंट्स? वी विल गेट दिस न्यूट्रिएंट्स फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फूड. एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ फूड्स वी विल गेट फ्रॉम द क्रॉप्स. एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ क्रॉप्स विल बी अकर ऑन दिस सॉइल. सो इन दिस वे सॉइल इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस. विदाउट सॉइल देर वुड बी नो ग्रास, नो क्रॉप्स, नो ट्रीज, नो फूड फॉर अस. Or for us or for other animals also, it would not possible for us to get crops and to get food for us also and for animal also. It is also the place where many organisms live. No life is possible without soil, we can say. No life is possible without soil. Now formation of soil. Now we will discuss about the formation of soil. Formation of soil, as we have known about the soil, soil is very important for us if we want to grow up, if we want to grow plants and trees, then they can grow only on land. So no life is possible, because if we want to eat food, then we need soil for growing up plants. Formation of soil is a very slow and gradual process. It is very slow process, not easy process to get soil. Formation of soil is very slow process. It takes thousands of years to form a layer of soils. How much year? How many years? Thousands of years they will take to form it a soil, to make a layer of soil. Soil is formed from the breakdown of rocks. In your previous classes, you have learned about the rocks and minerals. Rocks, by the action of water, ice, wave, using different agents, the breaking down of the rocks and go away from one place to another place with the blow of the water, and then they make the tiny particles of the rocks, and then after the soil will form. And we get the layer of the soil. The process of formation of soil from the breakdown of rocks is called weathering. The process in which we get the soil, this process is called the weathering, when the rocks will be breakdown. The nature of soil form depend upon the following three factors. The rocks from which it has been formed. Then second is the type of vegetation that grows in it. And the third is the climate of the place. These three factors most affected to the soil formation. Then how do certain agents bring about weathering of rocks? As we have discussed, different kinds of agents will break down the rocks, and by this process we will get the soil, the layer of the soil. Water plays an important role in this. In breaking large pieces of rocks into smaller places, rainwater enters the small pieces of rocks. In winter, the water bridges to form ice. In winter season, we all know the temperature in winter season. Winter season is very cold, so the water will freeze and convert into ice. When the ice in the crevices of these rocks expanded, it causes of crevices to open up further. This leads to the breakdown of rocks. It also results in the formation of smaller rocks of pieces. So like this, the water convert first in ice, then they will break down the rocks. Rain and river water further break the rock particles into fine grains by their upwards action. Wind blowing across a rocky surface also has an effect. It carries away the minute rock particles to other places. Wind take the particles from the rocks and take with them to one place to another places. Certain plants like lichen grow on the surface of rocks. These lichens produces acid. This type of plant will produce the acid which act on the rocky surface and produce the soil particles. In this process, we also get the soil particles because this type of plants will produce the acids and acids break down the rocks and we will get the particles of the rocks. So using this type of factors, the soil will be formed and the layer of the soil will be occur there and we will get the soil formation. Using soil formation, we will get the layer of the soil. Now, soil profile. Soil profile, usually we see the surface of the soil. We can see the top layer of the soil on the soil surface. If we look at the sides of a ditch or a place where the foundations for a building is being dug, we can see what is under the surface. By using this process, we can see under the surface. Such a view of soil is called the soil profile. If we can easily see the soil profile one by one layer of the soil when any construction will be going on, they dug the soil there, we can see easily the layer of the soil. It helps us to get an inner view of the soil. It will help us to get the inner surface of the soil. We can see that the soil is arranged in layers. As we say, the layers in cake. We have layers in cake available. First, we have chocolate layer, cream layer, the nugget chocolate layer. Like this, if we have dug in the layer, then we can see easily the layer of the soil is available there. This is called the horizons also. We have diagram for this. This is a diagram of soil profile. In this, we can see the A horizon, B horizon, and C horizon. That means soil has three layers. Soil profile has three layers: top soil, subsoil, and parent soil. Top soil is also known as A horizon. Then subsoil is known as B horizon, and parent rock is also known as C horizon. That means when we get the when we get to see the inner surface of the earth, then we can see easily the layer of the soil. The first of this is topsoil. Topsoil is also known as A horizon. The uppermost layer of the soil is called the topsoil. A horizon also we can see this. It is usually the darkest in color. You can see the ground color of your around you also. The color of the top soil is in which color? They are in darkest color. It is rich in humus. It is contains a lot of decaying plants and animals remains. They have humus in them. It makes the soil fertile. Some types of organisms also live there and they make the soil fertile. This layer is soil produce and can hold a lot of water because they have humus also. The roots of small plants are completely under the top soil. The small parts of plants can easily grow up with the top layer of the soil. In cases of trees, the roots will be go downside of the from at the B horizon also. But the small types of plants can easily grow with the top layer of the soil. It is the top soil from which plants get the essential nutrients. As I said to you, the top layer provide the nutrients and water easily to the plants. Then subsoil. Subsoil is also known as B horizon. The layer of below the topsoil is called the subsoil. Subsoil is also known as the B horizon. It is lighter in color than the topsoil. The color of the topsoil is the darkest color, but it is lighter than compared to topsoil. It is usually harder and more compact than the topsoil. It is rich in soluble minerals and iron oxide. As we get in top layer, we get the nutrients and water. Like this, in subsoil, it is soluble in minerals and iron oxides. It has very little humus compared to topsoil. Rainwater collects in this layer. Rain water will be collected in this layer. In which layer? In subsoil layer. Then parent rock. Parent rock is also known as sea horizon. The layer below the subsoil is called the parent rock or the sea horizon. They have also some features like subsoil and also the topsoil. It is made of small lumps of rocks with the space in between formed by cracks and crevices. Rain water collects in the regions also. Below the parent rock, there is solid rock called the bedrock. If we go downside of the last layer of the soil, sea horizon, then we get the bedrock also. It is hard and cannot be dug up with a spade. Rainwater collects over the bedrock, forming the water table. Then you know, textbooks also given activity 8.1 to study the soil profile. They given us some steps. Using these steps, you can read about this activity because it is not possible to solve at all this time. So try to read it. Then after composition of soil, our other topic is composition of soil. Soil consists of a number of components, not a single number components they use. They use a number of components, and these are components are the first is soil particles, humus, soil water, soil air, and soil organisms. Using these components, the soil composition is possible. Of these, soil particles are undoubtedly the main components. Soil particles are the main components. Humus is formed from the remains of dead and decaying animals and plants. They get using these things, the soil will get humus. Microorganisms help in this process of decay. Humus is source of nutrients and makes the soil fertile. Because if we want the proper growing of plants and animals, then we get the proper amount of fertility of the soil, and dead and decaying animals and plants will very useful to get the humus in soil, because the humus of soil is very important for better growing of plants and trees and another things. Soil organisms consist of earthworms, insects, etc. Snails. We can see the some types of organisms will live in earth. In them, earthworms are also called the friends of farmers because they go inside the soil and come out again, and doing different types of processes, they make the soil fertile, which is very useful to farmers. So they are also called the farmer's friend. Bacteria and fungi help in the decompositions of dead plants and animals. This process of releases the minerals back to soil, which can again be used by the plants and roots. Some bacteria convert some bacteria also convert to nitrogen into nitrogen compounds. Some types of nitrogen convert the nitrogen compounds, which can be used by plants. Nitrogen is very useful for plants, and this is possible by also the some types of bacteria which stay in soil. This is also known as nitrogen fixation. Let us then they give us some activities. After this composition of soil, let us discuss about them. Activity 8.2, to observe the presence of living organism in soil. In activity 8.2, they tell us observe about the some types of living organisms stay in the soil. For this, take the piece of land with either water or dilute solution of mustard seeds. Observe what happens. You will find there the earthworm, snail, insects live, and other small organisms of this stay in the soil. They show us the living organisms are staying there. For better understanding, you try to read activity 8.2. Then after we have activity 8.3. In activity 8.3, to show that soil contains water. All soil contains water. To prove them, to take some sample of swine and pack in a plastic bag and cover the plastic bag tightly and put in 1 or 2 hours against the sun. After some time you will get the water. After you will see the droplets of water inside the plastic bag, and that proves the sun, that shows us that the soil contains water. Then other activity to find out the moisture content a soil sample. They have tell us to count something. First they take the simple soil, then put in a sun against the sun. Then after they also calculate the sum, they weigh this the soil, the difference between the, then we get the weight. There is a different weight of the soil, the first normal soil and after doing some processes soil. So that also proves that the moisture content of a soil have. So using these activities we can also know more about the soil particles. Now soil particles. Soil consists of particles of different size. Based on size, soil particles are broadly divided into four types as given in our table. Soil particles, they are divided into four types. In table 8.1 you can see the type of particles: gravel or stone, sand, then another is silt and clay. Size, they have also give us size. Gravel and stone more than 2.0 mm, sand 0.05 to 2.0 mm, silt 0.002 to 0.05 mm, and clay less than 0.002 mm. Using these size you will clear about the types of particle, because we have different particles available in our soil, but using this size we can easily clear them which type of particles we have. So using this table you will get the information about this. Clay particles have the smallest size. In using tables you can see the clay smallest part, then silt, then salt, and bigger is gravel or stone. So soil particles is very useful to, soil particles are also very useful to composition of soil. So in this session we discussed about the soil, how soil is important. As soil is very important, as no life is possible for us and also other living organism without the soil. Using breaking down of the rocks we will get the layer of the soil, and we have different types of factors, agents. Using these agents we will get the layer of the soil. Then composition of the soil, how the soil will be composed. So our this topic is completed here. You can see here the topsoil, subsoil and also the parent rock. The color is different from each other, darkest, light, and it is also different from them. They have also different features available using their layer size. Okay, so our some topics is clear here. Now we will meet with our new topics in our next session.